Welcome friends, I have already discussed about the acids, their properties, their characteristics and their uses. Today I am going to discuss about the bases. All metallic oxides and hydroxides are called bases. So bases are metallic oxides and hydroxides. Metallic oxides, and hydroxides. All metallic oxides and hydroxides are called bases. Some of the oxides and hydroxides of metals are soluble in water, hence they are called alkalis. For example, sodium oxide, Na2O, it dissolves in water to give NaOH, sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide itself is soluble in water, and when it dissolves in water to give sodium hydroxide, it also soluble in water. Hence, sodium oxide or sodium hydroxide are called alkalis. Take another example, copper oxide. Copper oxide is also a base, just like sodium hydroxide, but copper oxide, it is a base. But it is insoluble in water. It is insoluble in water. And copper hydroxide, so formed using any other chemical method, also insoluble in water. So collectively, copper oxide or copper hydroxide or sodium hydroxide, sodium oxide can be called bases. They are bases. But particularly copper hydroxide, which is insoluble in water, also copper oxide and copper hydroxide, insoluble in water, they are simply bases. But since sodium oxides or hydroxide are completely soluble in water, hence they are called alkalis. So, it is very clear that when the metallic oxides or hydroxides are soluble in water, a special term given to them is called alkalis. So, all alkalis belong to the group of metallic oxides or hydroxides. They are simply bases. But copper hydroxide or copper oxide, since insoluble in water, it is simply base but not alkalis. So it is clearly said that alkalis can be termed as bases. That is, all alkalis are bases, but all bases are not alkalis. Very important thing is that, since if I represent this in the form of a Venn diagram, that suppose take this diagram for bases, among all metallic hydroxide are included in this group. This is bases, all metallic oxides and hydroxides are included in this group, but few of them are soluble in water. This part are called alkalis, because not, for example, sodium oxide, soluble in water, it also belongs to group of bases. Copper oxide It belongs to the group of bases, and since insoluble in water, it cannot be termed as alkalis. So, all alkalis belong to the group of bases. That is, all alkalis are bases. But conversely, you cannot say that all bases are alkalis. Very important thing. Characteristic qualities of the bases due to the degree of dissociation to form hydroxyl ion in water. That is, in the aqueous solution, to what extent the bases or alkali dissociate to form hydroxyl ion. That is, this is called hydroxyl ion gives the characteristics of the bases. Classification of base. Next one, the classification of base. Classification. Basis classification. Classification. Depending upon the degree of dissociation. Depending upon the degree of dissociation, the bases can be termed as weak and strong bases. That is, when a base give high concentration of hydroxyl ion, high concentration of OH ion or hydroxyl ion, that is, when a base completely dissociates, for example, sodium hydroxide or ammonium hydroxide, whatever, sodium hydroxide completely dissociate. Sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide completely dissociates. It completely dissociates to give two ions, one sodium ion and hydroxyl ion. That is how they completely dissociate to give hydroxyl ion or sodium ion, and there is high concentration of OH ion. So it is called, sodium is called strong base. One is strong base. When concentration is low, when this concentration is low, then when this concentration is low, then you can say that the base is weak. Low concentration of OH ion. Weak bases. For example, aluminium hydroxide. ALOH. This gives low concentration of OH ion. That means they dissociate partially, not completely, to give OH ion. That is, there is partial dissociation, not completely. For example, out of 100 molecules, only about 10 to 12 molecules can dissociate. But in case of high concentration of OH ion, almost there is 80 to 90% molecule dissociate to give OH ion. So when there is high concentration of OH, they are called strong bases. And when there is low concentration of OH ion, due to the partial dissociation of OH in the solution, in the aqueous solution, they are called weak bases. They are simply called weak bases. Another basis for classification is the acidity of bases. What is acidity of bases? It is the number of OH ion, that is hydroxyl ion, from one molecule of the concerned base. For example, sodium hydroxide gives one molecule of sodium hydroxide gives one OH. So acidity of base is 1. Here, only 1 ion from 1 molecule, only 1 hydroxyl ion from 1 molecule, so acidity is simply 1. 1 molecule of sodium hydroxide gives 1 ion of hydroxyl, 1 hydroxyl ion, so acidity is 1. Next one, take another example, calcium hydroxide. Calcium hydroxide, CaOH whole 2. Here it is, Ca, instead of N it would be Ca, Ca, and there will be two ions from one molecule. So acidity is simply 2. Taking another example, aluminium hydroxide. Aluminium hydroxide, AlOH whole 3. Here we get 3 hydroxyl ion and 1 aluminium ion. So from one molecule there is 3 hydroxyl ion after dissociation in the aqueous solution. So acidity of this base is 3. So depending upon the acidity, we can classify the bases as monoacidic, monodiacidic and triacidic. As in case of acid, we say the basicity of the acids, simply there is the acidity of bases. So depending upon the acidity, we can classify them as monoacidic, diacidic, triacidic, etc., etc. Okay, thank you all for the day.